Football is a 20th century technological struggle.
And what I seen was this whole raft of people a-setting on these two banks and looking at one another across this pretty little green cow pasture.
Football has hitting, clipping, spearing, blocking, punting, late hitting, unnecessary roughness, and personal fouls.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Stanley County Monday Night Football. Charles Kirschner with the Stanley News and Press alongside Brian Carter of Carter Video Services, week 4 of the season. And we are here at North Stanley High School for a game that feels a lot less like a normal regular, sort of a non-conference regular season game and more of a heavyweight title fight because there is a title on the line tonight. West Stanley comes to North Stanley with the Colts having a chance to win the Stanley Cup with a win tonight over North Stanley, over the Comets. We see West Stanley warming up behind us. We've seen them for the first 3 weeks of the season, winning at home against South Stanley, losing to West Montgomery, and then the shutout win 6-0 last week over Albemarle, ending a couple of long streaks for the Bulldogs. Malik Jackson is the leading rusher, has 5 touchdowns for the Colts. They're going to run a 3-2 and 3 wide receiver sets with one back. Quarterback right there is number 12, Christian Boone, and his backup is number 4, Taylen Rowe. And Rowe can also, not only is he a good quarterback, but he also plays wide receiver, and you would probably see him on some screen passes as well. Our first look this year at North Stanley, 1-1 on the season, opened the season with a win at Bunker Hill, then lost 2 weeks ago to Sun Valley, 64-38. The Comets, of course, their man, number 34, Antonio Williams, the leading rusher in Stanley County, now sits somewhere unofficially around 14th in the state, history-wise, in career rushing yards. And he looks to add and possibly continue to move up that list, even getting up closer to the Stanley County record, of course, held by T.A. McClendon with his 9,003 career rushing yards. It's West Stanley and North Stanley. West Stanley can win the cup with a win tonight. We'll be back with the coaches on Stanley County Monday Night Football. Yeah. Back here on the pregame show on Stanley County Monday Night Football with West Stanley head coach Eric Moorman. Coach, let's talk a little bit about defense last week against Albemarle, pitching the shutouts. The first time West had done it in quite a while, and it was the first shutout for Albemarle in nearly 7 or 8 years. Talk about this team's defense and how it sort of has developed over the first 3 games.
Overall, we want to make sure that we're a defensive team. It's our 11 best. And so, defensive last week, the guys came out, they competed, they were disciplined, and they understand what they have to do. For tonight, hopefully, we follow the game plan. We come out, be disciplined again. Hopefully, we cause some more turnovers just like last week.
And then, obviously, any team that takes North Stanley on this year has got to worry about number 34. Can you scheme against just one guy, or does it have to be a number of guys that have to join in for this effort?
When you turn on the film, you obviously can see that number 34 is a great player. But it's not so much about North Stanley. It's all about our kids coming out following our game plan. We have to come out and play West Stanley football, make sure we've been disciplined, reading our keys, and just follow our game plan. Just make sure we're doing what we're supposed to do.
A win tonight would bring the Stanley Cup back to West Stanley. What would that mean to you and to this program?
It would be great for the program overall. I don't think it's happened in a while. I will tell you the kids are ready. They're going to come out and compete, and that's what we do at West Stanley. We want to be a physical team that comes out first class and competes.
Coach, best of luck tonight in the game against North Stanley.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
We'll be back in just a moment with North Stanley head coach Scott Crisco. Back here on the pregame show on Stanley County Monday Night Football with North Stanley head coach Scott Crisco. Coach, we hear your team getting fired up behind us. Talk a little bit about the season so far for North Stanley. A win on the road at Bunker Hill and then the loss 2 weeks ago to Sun Valley.
Yeah, the Bunker Hill was an important win for us because it's our first win, kind of getting the season going, figuring out what we're doing and what we got, and it helped us give a little confidence to our guys. Sun Valley, even though it was a loss, I really think it helped us get some confidence too, you know, going into a 3A school. And, you know, like I said before, we were ahead in the game in the third quarter and just start losing players and couldn't recover from it. But that's what we've been using the last 2 weeks is motivation.
Matchup tonight with West Stanley. West can win the Stanley Cup with a win. North can prevent that from happening with a win. What's that kind of preparation been like for this week? Obviously, always a county game, so it's always going to be a rivalry there. But it seemed like maybe just a little added something this week.
Yeah, it's like I told our guys. You know, when you play Northmore and Chatham Central, you don't see those guys every day at Walmart and wherever. But you know, here in county games, you know, you're going to see them all the time. So it's a pride game. That's what I've been calling it, a pride game.
How do these two teams match up?
I think we match up pretty good. We both have very good running backs who can score at will and get outside, physical. Both have a pretty good line, and both have some question marks coming into the season and something to prove.
Coach, best of luck tonight in your game against West Stanley.
Thank you. Thank you.
We'll be back with the kickoff on Stanley County Monday Night Football. This is going to be a good one.
Gentlemen, we're here at R.N. Jeffrey Stadium for the battle between West Stanley and North Stanley here on a wonderful Friday night. I'm Brian Carter with Carter Video Services here alongside Charles Kersey.
You can get it out eventually, yeah.
West Stanley Monday Night Football, Stanley County Monday Night Football, and the Stanley News and Press. Hello, Charles. You take it from here.
Well, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We've got a really big show tonight. Tonight actually feels a lot less like a normal regular season game between West Stanley and North Stanley, and a heck of a lot more like a heavyweight title fight, because there is a title on the line right now.
Number 75.
And we'll get to that in just a second. Beautiful work on the field with that red, white, and blue. North Stanley's won the toss. Will receive, and they will move left to right across the television screen. Again, West Stanley, we have already seen three times this year, and of course, two of those wins came against Stanley County teams. One more win for the Colts, and they win the Stanley Cup for 2015. Outright, no questions asked. If North Stanley wins, then the Comets, it's not that they keep the title, but necessarily that they've denied West Stanley the title outright, and then have a chance, and gives Albemarle and South a chance to possibly force some sort of a tie later in the season. It's going to be very interesting to see how that develops over the season, if that were to happen.
Yeah, we're looking at North Stanley getting ready to get on the field and see Antonio Williams going to lead the pack. And can you read that, Charles?
It says, close your eyes and kiss your winning dreams goodbye.
Uh-oh.
And here come the West Stanley Colts.
Fighting words.
Here comes West Stanley, 2-1 on the season. Last week, 6-0 shutout of Albemarle, the first shutout Albemarle had suffered in 110 consecutive games dating back to 2007, and the first win for a Stanley County team against Albemarle since 2006.
And here come the Comets.
Led by number 34, Antonio Williams, the Wisconsin commit. The Comets have a little something to say about, and probably will have something to say about, that Stanley Cup that North Stanley won for the first time last season.
And I'm sure they want to hold on to that cup, Charles.
Absolutely. The cup has been awarded since 93, so it's not the first county championship for North Stanley, but it was the first time that the cup was awarded to the Comets.
And yes, there was a mistake in the roster. Another captain for West Stanley High School was number one, Caleb Wilson.
What do you think the Comets have to do to keep Malik Jackson in check?
Well, Malik, obviously that is one player that's going to be keyed on by North Stanley. I think they have to Wes Montgomery did a good job of it, and actually Albemarle did as well most of that game. Really didn't give up any big plays to Malik. You've got to get penetration. You've got to get – and you've got to contain on the outside. Mm-hmm. I don't know that – Malik will want to run as much between the hash marks as he will try to bust it to the outside and just kind of veer outside. And the other side, Antonio Williams can run it inside, outside.
He can do just shake and bake Williams.
Anything he wants. I think with containing Williams is really a very difficult proposition. You just have to get as many hacks to the ball as you can.
And the Colts are going to kick off to the Comets here.
Crazies on one side. The Comet crazies on this side. West Stanley, North Stanley. The cup is on the line. Let's roll. Logan Green with an end-over-end kick. Going to be taken into the end zone for a touchback by number 89, L.J. Rush. And it'll come out to the 20.
89, L.J. Rush with the return for the Comets. Ball will be spotted at the 20. Comets, first and 10.
So Green always gives West Stanley an added weapon just on special teams with his ability for kickoff with kickoffs. And Brian, he's already put the Comets back deep in their own territory. Starting quarterback for North Stanley, of course, is number two, Noah Crisco. The Comets will come out in almost a run-and-shoot look, really. Williams is the lone back. Four wide receivers on first and 10. Little motion to the near side of the field. It's going to be Williams. Cuts inside. Runs into the official. Oh, just pulled him
over. What about that? Runs over the official.
And gets about 9 yards on the play.
Referee timeout.
And the referee needs
good tackle by the referee.
Needs a timeout. And if he didn't make the tackle, he at least slowed him up. Working. No huddle. Oh, and this snap goes well over the head of Crisco, and he's going to fall on it. A big loss on the play back to the 15-yard line. So it turns what was second down and one into third down and 15. So it's actually, it comes as a net loss of 14 yards and will be third down and 15 now, or third down and 16 rather, or 14 rather, from the 16. That's easy for me to say.
Not a good start for the offense.
Well, it was a good start, but then it looked like North Stanley was wanting to run a little no-huddle offense, and I don't know if they were maybe on the wrong, the different snap count or something, Brian, but that snap just went flying over Noah Crisco's head. Now motion again. Four wide receivers. Going to be Williams off the left side. Now cuts up the middle, and he could be gone. 50, 40, 30. See you later. Touchdown, North Stanley Comets. An 84-yard touchdown run.
As the confetti comes out.
As confetti comes out, and the Comets lead 50 seconds into the game.
Well, they definitely made up for that loss.
And 50 seconds into this game, North Stanley is already on the board. 6-0, pending the point after. The kicker is number 7, Tyler Billingsley, kicking out of the hold of 80, Jordan Howard.
Yeah, let's get a good look at the kicking game of North Stanley here.
And the kick is up, and that kick looks good. It is no good. He's pushed it. Pushed it to the right. So with 11:10 left, opening quarter, North Stanley 6, West Stanley nothing. We'll be back on Stanley County Monday Night Football. So Antonio Williams with an 84-yard touchdown run, converting a third down and 14 after a bad snap and a three-play scoring drive for the Comets. North Stanley leads 6-0. Low end-over-end kick. Going to be Izaguirre fumbles it at the 5. He'll pick it up at the 10 off the deck. 15. Still trying to find some room, trying to dance, but he is not going to. He's going to run out of room at around the 17.
And Izaguirre, the folks out there Izaguirre. Don't know.
Izaguirre. I will pronounce his name right if it takes me all year long.
He was our player of the week last night. He had a tremendous game last week, Charles.
He absolutely did.
Scored the only touchdown for the Colts.
He came in. Malik Jackson wasn't injured. He was hurt. He had a cramp, and he came out for a couple of plays, and Izaguirre took advantage of it and took the ball. For the touchdown. Malik Jackson on first and 10 now makes a couple of moves. Going to be number 41 finishes him off, C.J. Harris.
Oh, C.J. Harris. I remember watching him in the youth football years ago.
Gain is about 3 on the play. It's going to bring up second down and 7.
Can you tell me, Charles, what are the Comets? They have signs up on the sideline, holding up signs. What do you think that is?
I'll tell you in a minute. Second down and 7. Boone looking to swing that, completes to number 10, but no gain on the play and a great tackle. 14 on it is Landon Williams with the pass was complete to Wahlberg, Logan Wahlberg. But he actually loses 4 yards on the play.
And that'll bring up third down.
Thanks to a good tackle by Landon Williams. And it brings up third and about 11.
Third and 10 now.
Clock continuing to run, as you said. 10 minutes left. Third quarter, Colts now facing third down and 10. 3 wide receivers to the far side. Boone looking for room to throw. He puts it up there for Rowe. It's incomplete over Rowe's head. He was covered on the play pretty well by number 20 Cameron Davis and 28 Austin Sides, although he was open on the play, but it will count as a fourth down now and probably a punting situation for Logan Green.
Well, let's see if Green can put some razzle-dazzle on that ball and try to pin him back a little bit.
So you asked me about the signs earlier. That's probably a call playing system that they're using to let them know on the wristbands and different things what the call is. It's a low end-over-end punt. It's sort of a short punt.
Did
he touch that ball? If he didn't, I would pick it up.
The Colts were going to go with it.
They're going to say that Cameron Davis didn't touch it, but if he didn't touch it, he came as close. You couldn't humanly possibly get to a punt without touching it.
Sausage biscuits. Go and get me one at halftime.
So 9 minutes. No, I am not. 35 seconds left. Get your own sausage biscuits.
I'm not worth a sausage biscuit. That's pretty bad.
Six nothing. North Stanley leading West Stanley. 9:35 left in the opening quarter. Williams, the second play, a third play from scrimmage, his second carry of the game was an 84-yard touchdown. You know, when we started this season, he needed somewhere around 3,000 yards. I think it was like around 3,100 yards or so
to break TA's
to surpass TA's career record. Now we have a penalty on the play against West Stanley. I didn't see any indication of what the call was.
Well, let's check that penalty.
Oh, is it a block in the back against West Stanley? And this marks the ball down to the 35-yard line. Down to the West 35. And the Comets with excellent field position. This time, I believe that was Monty Brewer.
Number 20, Cameron Davis.
Or excuse me, 20, Cameron Davis.
I think he picked up about 4 yards on that.
He'll get maybe 3 or 4 to bring up second down. They'll give him two on the play. We'll bring up second down and eight. Running no huddle once again. Now looking over the side, incomplete. I think he was about a half second ahead of his receiver, Davis, that time. Crisco was looking, I think Crisco was looking for him on that, on a little curl pattern. He just didn't have time to actually curl to the, or flag pattern, you know, to the corner there. So it'll bring up third down and eight. Third and eight now for the Comets from the Colt 33. Give to Williams, and he is stacked up this time. Right in the hands of who? Connor Edwards.
Good defensive stand for the Colts.
Well, after shorter punt and a penalty, actually going to give Williams a two-yard loss that time. It'll bring up fourth down and 10. An interesting choice here.
I think they're going for
it. At the 35, I can't say I blame North Stanley for trying. When you convert a third down and 14, I would have to say that it would give you some confidence that you would be able to convert anything. But North Stanley now we have an official timeout. I think it may be for an equipment problem. They were checking to make sure that Antonio had a mouth guard. And now going to, it looks like, the back judge, JT Bust, trying to ask him to make sure it's a proper piece of equipment. Football is a lot like baseball in the sense that there are so many official types of equipment you can have. You have to have a certain kind of bat and ball and glove and all that sort of thing. Crisco going to throw, and it's through the hands of number 81, Wes Reynolds. And Wes Stanley will take over with 8 minutes and 7 seconds left.
Attention, Stuart C. Barbie, if you could please report to the concession.
So Wes Stanley gets a hold on their second defensive stand of this game. And now brings the offense back on the field. And I have a quick official timeout while it looks like a football got away from one of the football kids, that one of the kids that bring in the footballs and stuff. And now we're ready to go, first and 10 from the 35. Going to be Jackson's got a lead block in front of him. Cuts, tries to cut another way. He's got a first down. Still more, still going. And finally, he'll get knocked out of bounds hard at the 45, and very lucky North Stanley is that a late hit didn't come out there, because those were really big shots right just as he was going out of bounds.
Now we see the Colts offense taking off here.
A 20-yard gain and a first down for Wes Stanley. Going to be Jackson again. He's hit immediately by number 52, I believe, on the tackle was C.J. Clark.
And he skirts for about three yards.
They're actually only going to mark him for about a yard gain. Brian will bring up second down and nine. Clock continuing to run, 7:24 left, opening quarter. Wes Stanley and North Stanley. Colts trailing the Comets 6-0. Three wide receivers once again. Brown is the H-back. Jackson gets the carry. Great blocking. 30, he's got one man to beat. Tries to get past him, and he is gone. There's a flag down. And at around the 30-yard line, there was a block in the back. So it will not be a touchdown, but it will be a first down. It should be for Wes Stanley. The penalty was at the 31-yard line.
Oh, what a terrific run by Malik.
Good job following his blockers.
And the indication, though, it is against West Stanley. We'll mark the ball back to the North Stanley 41-yard line. I didn't see what the actual call was, but I believe it was like it was a block in the back.
Yeah.
Now we're going to get a timeout from West Stanley, and we'll take one as well. 6:59 left, opening quarter. North Stanley 6, West Stanley nothing. So two timeouts remaining for West Stanley. 6:59 left in this opening quarter. Colts trailing the Comets 6-0. A little discussion here. If I had to guess, Brian, I think the discussion here is regarding if it's still first down or if it's second down. I know that in some cases when you get a gain downfield, like, for example, if the penalty had been at the 10, they would have moved it to the 20, but it had been a first down.
Yeah, I think that's part of what they're discussing now.
It's not the old kind of – it's a spot foul. So
they're discussing this for a long time.
I'm not sure what it should be. I'm merely commenting that – if it's anything, it's either second and six or first and six.
I think the officials are a little confused also.
And it's a spot foul, but the question is what effect it has on the down in this case. Since the gain was obviously in the end zone, obviously a first down, but the penalty was actually beyond the first down marker as well. So while we're getting this conversation from the officials, quickly, North Stanley, 5 carries, 80 yards, net yards. Antonio Williams, 3 carries, already 91 yards and a touchdown. Malik Jackson, 4 carries, 37 yards.
And
this is really going to be a battle between two running backs.
Yeah, the officials going over, the head linesman going over and talking to Coach Moorman.
He's a little confused.
And
I think he's... wanting to and getting possibly an explanation about that call. And I think that's what the discussion was about. Nonetheless,
I think they're going to keep it the
second
down
and
six.
Second down and six. Three wide receivers this time. Rowe and Justin Balcom to the near side. It's going to be Jackson. Gets through the initial defense. 30, still on his feet. Oh, he tried to cut back, still on his feet. 25, oh, he breaks another tackle. He could be gone. He is gone. Touchdown, West Stanley Colts.
Incredible.
And this time there are no flags on the field.
And the Colt fans are loving it across the field here.
So with 6 minutes and 43 seconds left, West Stanley is one extra point away from taking the lead back. Green now out of the hold of Wahlberg. Snaps a little low, got under it just a little bit, but that kick is good. 6:43 left, opening quarter. West Stanley 7, North Stanley 6. We'll be right back. West Stanley leading North Stanley. And I'll tell you what, we have got ourselves a terrific game so far. We have a game really between two running backs. It's just going to be a question of which one gets stopped first.
Very true, Charles. I mean,
Jackson finished off that last drive with a 41-yard touchdown run.
Here we go with the kick.
Green now, end over end kick. Going to be a little shorter this time, taken at the 3-yard line by Jordan Howard. And now, oh, baby, does Jordan Howard get absolutely buried?
And who was that?
Mr.
Edwards.
Edwards, yes, it was.
Oh, he's slow getting up.
He's looking for the number of the train that just hit him. He absolutely had him just textbook squared up.
Connor Edwards, I mean, he should get defensive player of the year here.
He very well may. You know, that is something that the Stanley News and Press awards every year.
Well, I think he's in the contention, don't you think?
I would say most definitely.
What a massive hit.
Massive hit.
I heard up here.
Sets up the Comets first and 10 at the 16. Going to be Williams. Nice spin move. Look out. Oh, one man to beat. If he had gotten past that final man, which I believe was
it was number 25 20, that stopped him.
25 is Lawson Udy. And Udy saved a touchdown there, I guarantee.
Absolutely. He needs to get a big pat on the back for that.
He was the last line of defense.
He just managed to grab him by the ankle, take him down.
That run was 18 yards, and it puts it already, Williams, with four carries, is over 100 yards. Four wide receivers this time. First and 10. Crisco going to throw, and it's batted down. And I'll tell you what, Drew Kidd almost had a chance. So he almost looked like he was going to bat that to himself.
Crisco's pass is knocked down by number 40, Drew Kidd.
That brings up second down and 10. Second and 10 this time, little motion. It's going to be Williams. Edwards gets the first shot on him, and he gets some help then afterwards.
Number 34, Williams up the middle for the Comets.
And nothing going there. I think he might have lost.
Matter of fact, they are going to mark him back at the 33. It's a loss of a yard.
Yeah.
And they'll bring a third down and 11. Williams on a draw play. No, it's Crisco on a keeper. 35, trying to turn the corner. 40, he's going to come up short of the first down. Well-designed play. And
Nice misdirection.
Noah sold it well, but he just didn't have enough real estate, really. That's almost a play that if you're North Stanley, might be better run to the far side of the field because he could at least angle his way. He had tacklers coming, but he just ran out of real estate. So fourth down, and it's going to be a punting situation. C.J. Crisco booming, spiraling, end over end. Beautiful. Kick's going to sit right down at the Colt 24-yard line.
Punt by number 41, C.J.
5:44 left in the first quarter.
Take the ball at the 24-yard line.
And we have an official timeout, maybe for a water break. It is a water break. We're going to take a quick timeout, Brian. We'll be right back. West Stanley leading North Stanley 7-6 here in the first quarter.
I think I'll take some water, too.
First and 10 now for West Stanley from the Colt 24-yard line. The Colts lead 7-6, 5:44, as you saw, left in the opening quarter. Jackson now cuts up the middle. Spun around. Nice tackle on the play. I believe that was 21, Taylor Chandler.
You're correct.
Tackle right at the 27. Gain of three brings up seven, we'll call it seven. You're going to see a steady diet of Williams versus Jackson on this one.
I was about to say.
And it's sort of poetic considering the game. Now a long pass going towards the sidelines, incomplete. There was contact.
Number 12, Christian Bennett.
I think almost actually, I thought Taylen Rowe actually got his hands on Davis and became the defensive player and may have interfered slightly. But no flag forthcoming, and it brings up third down and seven. You know, a lot of times you'll see a reversal of fortune, if you will, a reversal of roles, I guess is a better way to put it, when you see a long pass go out like that and it's either underthrown or overthrown and the defensive player has a better shot at it. And they kind of switch roles as who's going to get the ball. Two wide receivers this time. Make that three wide receivers. Taylor is to the far side. Going to be Jackson trying to get a block in front of him. He's going to push the pile forward to the 31 and be well short of the first down.
Yeah, so the Colts will have to kick it away here. And the first quarter here with 4:52 to go.
Green will punt this one away, standing at his own 15. And instead of Jordan Howard, it's now number 20, Cameron Davis, standing at around the 35-yard line. By the way, we mentioned it is 9-11, and we want to send out our thoughts and prayers, of course, to those that were affected by that tragedy those years ago. Once again, Davis gets just dangerously close to that punt.
A little too close here.
I mean, if you're not going to
return... I think Coach Crisco needs to tell him, it's like, just stay away from the ball.
If you're not going to return the punt, I mean, I don't know how close you really need to get to that football when it's just dancing around like that. You know, it doesn't roll like a football, like a normal ball that's a sphere. It's, you know, it's an oblong-shaped ball.
It can take any kind of jump, crazy
bounces. Yeah.
And you're right, Charles. We should remember, you know, 9/11, 2001.
And I wanted to mention that because they did take a moment before the game to honor those affected by that and to think of the memories of that. But also the beautiful paint job at the Comet logo at the middle of the field. Oh, and this time, Wes Stanley just sandwiches the ball carrier.
I think 55 was in on that tackle.
81, Wes Reynolds was on the carrying. It was Kyle Pennington with the tackle. The jet sweep did not work that time for a loss of about a yard to bring up second down and 11. You know, when you see a battle between two outstanding players, especially when they play the same position, player, I feel like, that has to step up somewhere
to make the difference
and make a play of some sort. Now this pass is complete on the outside. First down. Tackled on the play by number five, Lucas Scott. And the pass was complete to the former Bulldog baseball player, Preston Burleson, down to the 41 for first down, making a 42. Gain of 15. That's Crisco's first completion of the game. Had thrown two incompletions. He's now, or maybe had three, and now he's one of four for 15 yards.
Yeah, and get that first completion. I'll get his confidence back there.
Crisco again looking to throw. Now runs that protection, runs out of time. Complete to Tyler Reynolds, 45, 50 into Colt territory. Fumbles the football, but he was already out of bounds. He's got a first down, though, right at the Colt 46.
I think he was trying to stretch the ball to get some extra yardage there.
Well, that's an admirable goal. It's just a question.
But you take a chance.
Ball security is paramount, you know.
That comes first.
You got to be careful. A slight haze sitting over R.N. Jeffrey Stadium that may or may not be coming directly from the hamburger grill.
And it does smell good, folks. If we had
smell-o-vision, you'd know it. Four wide receivers this time, first and 10. Crisco again, now quick short pass, complete. 35, 30, and down around the 27. Nice play to Jordan Howard.
Ah, Mr. Crisco is on fire here.
Well, they've completed a couple of passes and now have the ball down to the 26. That's a 20-yard gain on that one and a first down. And as we said, Williams, somebody else besides Williams or Jackson is going to have to step up in this game.
And that's what's happened.
And
you
so
predicted
far,
it.
Noah Crisco is doing it on this particular drive. First and 10 for the Comets now at the Colt 26. Comets trailing 7-6. Pass now to the far side, complete. Nice open field number tackle two, that time. I think it was Nate Taylor on the tackle.
Yeah, number 24.
And 24 is Riley
number
Smith
four,
with the catch.
Two, Noah Crisco. We have second and two for the Comets.
They'll mark the ball at the 18-yard line. A gain of 8 brings up second down and 2.
What is that, 4 completions for Noah?
It is. First off, if you're just joining us, shame on you. And in the second verse, if you're just joining us, you've missed already 2 terrific touchdown runs in this first quarter. Now Crisco going to throw again, looking for the end zone. Oh, he had a man open, and it's incomplete. Cameron Davis, I didn't see Cameron until he got just got past Number 25, that's Lawson Udy.
That one snuck by me right there.
And it really did. And I bring up third down, but it's a good spot if you're going to throw to the end zone. It's a good spot for that. And Coach Mormon is going to take a timeout. So we'll take one with exactly 2 minutes left, opening quarter. West Stanley 7, North Stanley 6.
That'll be a timeout.
Third down and about 2 for the Comets into the red zone. And now I believe West Stanley jumped. Yes, yeah. I believe the hard count got him.
The Comets are indicating and it's that's on the other side.
That'll be a first down at the 13. West Stanley is backing up, so that must be what it is. It is indeed.
Let's check the official.
So offsides.
And offsides, Colts. First down.
That's 3 penalties already in this first quarter for the Colts. One calling a touchdown back, but the Colts then scored on the very next play. Now Crisco, and I think they may have just given the 5 yards back. Well, Crisco might have just flinched a little bit. So I think we're going to get a false start. We will.
Yep.
So it'll be first and 15. So on the second, his second run of the game, the third offensive play from scrimmage, North Stanley's Antonio Williams with an 84-yard touchdown run down the sideline. But on the very next possession, Malik Jackson actually ran the ball in twice into the end zone. One didn't count on a penalty. The second attempt did from 41 yards out. The extra point was good. And now we have our 7-6 score. First and 15 now for the Comets. Comets look like they might have moved early. Passes incomplete and nearly that picked off.
Nearly picked off.
But Lawson Udy jumped the route.
Number 25. And he is holding his hand. I think he got it jammed.
Well, I can imagine why. It was between he and the receiver and the football, and they all three kind of met together in one little
You ever
moment.
Got your fingers jammed by a football?
It hurts. I've gotten my fingers jammed by a football, a basketball.
Baseball.
A hockey stick. I've had the back of my hand whacked several times by a hockey stick. That hurts too. So you can see North Stanley trying to establish, using the run almost to establish the pass because
no one's not afraid to throw the ball. Now he goes to Antonio.
Here's Williams around the end. 15, 10, 1 man to beat, and he is in. But there is a penalty down. There was a great block on the outside by Tyler Reynolds, but I don't think this touchdown is going to catch. Excuse me, it's going to count, rather. It was in the middle of the field, and it is holding.
Yeah, I'll back it up for 10.
That'll be holding against the Comets.
And it may have even been Tyler Reynolds. He had a great block on the outside, but he may have had too good of a block. I really didn't see who the hold was on. So they'll mark the ball back to the 15-yard line, it looks like. A 10-yard penalty. But it turns into a 15-yard penalty. That's the problem about these spot fouls. It's going to be second down and 12 now. North Stanley can get a first down at about the 4-yard line.
I'll tell you, Crisco is getting pretty confident in the air. I wouldn't be surprised to see a pass here.
Well, the short passing game has done well for the Comets. 4 of 9 now for 55 yards.
And that's what the Colts have to look out for here.
After throwing 3 incompletions to start things. Now Williams tries to cut up the middle. Puts his feet, dives to the end zone. He's going to be just short.
No, a little short, a little short.
But he's got a first down.
That'll be good enough for a comment. First down.
So they'll give him a first and goal at about the 3-yard line. Williams' numbers already into triple digits. 7 carries for 133 yards. First and goal now from the 3.
Do you think Noah tried to take this in himself?
Well, before we get that, we're going to get a timeout, and it'll be North Stanley. We'll take one as well. 1:27 left, opening quarter. Comets threatening, trailing 7-6. To the strains of Welcome to the Jungle, we're back, first and goal. Straight up the middle this time. The up back, and it's a touchdown. North Stanley Comets. Number 30, Mike Peoples. So the fullback gets the dive play and just goes straight over for a touchdown. And the Comets retake the lead.
And the mighty blue flags are waving.
Tyler Billingsley for the extra point. Oh, actually, they're going for two. Excuse me. And it's going to be Williams off the left side. Gets a great lead block, and he's in. Just powers up the left side. Wait, there's a flag down. So let's see what the penalty is first.
I think this may be against West.
Holding against North Stanley. No, it is not. So it's going to be a 10-yard penalty. And they'll have to retry.
I don't know, Charles. Would you still try to go for two?
No, I think you kick a field. I think you kick here. You know, the NFL was doing extra points from the 15. I like that. Make it a little challenging. This would be... This ball is going to be sitting around the 14. Tyler Billingsley is the kicker. Number 80, Jordan Howard, the holder. That kick is up. That's a beautiful end of her end kick. And
oh,
that
beautiful.
Is good. 1:24 left in the first quarter. North Stanley 13, West Stanley 7. So Mike Peoples finishes off the drive for North Stanley with a 3-yard run for the touchdown, and Comet's extra point is good this time. And now Comets retake the lead 13-7. You get the impression, Brian, that maybe we might be in for a high-scoring game?
Could be. I mean, this has been a long quarter. We still have a minute 24 left in this first quarter.
Low end-over-end kick this time. Going to be taken by Rowe. Rowe runs into his own blocker. And be down around the 27.
Let's see if the Colts have an answer for the Comets here. Wow, look at this crowd, Charles.
Is it a lot of people? I think a lot of people also realize the significance of this game as much as anything else.
It's almost like homecoming or something.
It really is. I formation this time, first and 10. Jackson, he is hit hard. I think that might have been C.J. Clark.
Jackson on the middle for the lost.
C.J. Harris, I'm sorry, excuse me. There is a C.J. Clark, but it wasn't 52. It was 41 that led the charge, and Malik lost a yard. I'm going to bring up second and 11. I formation once again. Jackson again. Oh, fumble on the play. Jackson appears to fall. Oh, I don't think he did fall on it.
Oh,
he had a shot at it. But
momentarily,
it
but number 52 picked it up. 52.
That's number 52 is C.J. Clark.
You know, Malik had possession for a while. He fell on it, but then he lost it.
So a critical turnover, and the first turnover of the game goes against West Stanley. Ball is resting now at the 23-yard line. He had a shot at that.
I hear some Ric Flair, woo, out there.
Yeah, I hear a few of those, yes. With 28 seconds left, now looking through the end zone for Tyler Reynolds. Goes up for it, and he had a shot at it, and it threw his hands incomplete.
Pretty much a jump ball, but pretty accurate.
And if you notice something, Brian, they're paying a lot of attention to the right side of the field, and they're throwing it at Lawson Uni and not throwing at the other side of the field where Nate Taylor, the taller defensive back, is.
That's a good observation there, Charles.
Thank you. That's why I get paid the big bucks.
You better start earning
it. The big bucks. I thought that was a funny joke. Oh, well. Second and 10 now. Four wide receivers. Here's Williams. Across the right side, 20, and Edwards will finish off the tackle. That I believe that's 40. Drew Kidd.
And Edwards started helps
at
him
the
out.
20, so a gain of about 3. It'll be a third down and 7. And for the second time in this game, North Stanley is into West Stanley's red zone. And I think they're going to play for the wait to change fields and play this in the second quarter. And there goes the horn. So after one quarter of play, your score, North Stanley 13 and West Stanley 7 on Stanley County Monday Night Football. We're back for the second quarter on Stanley County Monday Night Football. Charles Churchill for Santa News and Press and Brian Carter of Carter Video Services, third down and 7. But first,
another break.
I think we have another break. We do. It's going to be a timeout, and Wes Stanley calling it. That's their second. We'll be back in just a moment. So Wes Stanley with one timeout left in this first half. Now third and 7 for the comments. And we have a
Wes Stanley, I think, flinched.
The hard count once again looked like it may have gotten Wes Stanley. Let's see what the call is. Offsides is going to make third and 7. An easier and more easily converted second and 2. Taking a quick glance at first quarter stats.
And Antonio's in for the touchdown.
Oh, he's in. Touchdown. So quickly, I was still trying to look at something else.
If you look away for a second, folks, you'll miss something.
The Comets immediately convert the penalty, or the turnover rather, into a 15-yard Antonio Williams touchdown. With 11 minutes and 56 seconds left, 19-7 now. I don't think the kicker is in. I think they're going for 2 once again.
That's probably a wise decision. I mean, you were commenting on that earlier.
Well, you don't want to go for 2 points unless you absolutely have to from a distance other than there. Oh, fumble on the play. It's going to be recovered by Wes Stanley, and the try is no good.
The 2-point conversion is no good, but he'll score.
So, North Stanley 19, West Stanley 7, 11:56 left. Second quarter. We'll be right back. So with 11 minutes and 50 seconds left in the first half, Antonio Williams scores his second touchdown of the game. And if I remember correctly, that's his 8th touchdown on the season. I believe he had 6 coming in. I'll have to check that in just a second. Now the kickoff, nice high end over end kick. Going to be fumbled by Izaguirre at the 5. Izaguirre picks it up, trying to follow behind his blockers, but just never got ahead of speed particularly, and we'll get down around the 25.
22, Joseph Ligru.
And return to the 22-yard line is where they're going to mark it. Jackson with a rare fumble, and the Comets cashed it in.
Yeah, this game is far from over, far from over.
Before the pass, we have penalty markers, and I think Jackson moved early. I think he had started about a half step before the...
That's probably back him 5 yards back. Yep.
False start call against the Colts. Take it back 5.
That'll be first and 15. So in the first quarter, North Stanley had 9 first downs, West Stanley 2. Net rushing yards, 135 for North, 80 for West. Passing yards, minus 4 for West and 55 for North Stanley. And West Stanley did have each team had three penalties for 25 yards in the first quarter. So a lot of penalties actually for one quarter of play. First and 15 now from the pistol set. Fakes the give, now we'll keep it. I'm not sure if that was a designed give or not.
Yeah, I was wondering if that was by design or.
C.J. Harris gets the tackle at the 20. Gain of 3 on the play. It brings up second down and about, well, 2 to make it second down and 13. Three wide receivers this time, 2 to the far side. Nate Taylor, the lone receiver to the near side for the Colts on second down and about 13. Jackson trying to go off the left side, tripped up. I think 77, Austin Parker might have gotten a hand on him before he really got a head of steam.
21 on the tackle there.
And he was finished off, like you say, by 21, Taylor Chandler. Ball's resting at the 22. It brings up third down and 11. And now we have a whistle and another stoppage of play. I think we may have had a clock. The clock is continuing to run. Well, we have maybe an equipment problem of some sort.
Shouldn't they stop the clock, Charles?
They should stop the clock. They ran about 20.
Now the officials to wind the clock, but they never stopped it.
So lost about 20 seconds on that. Third down and 11 now. Boone trying to roll to his right a little. Looks over the middle, complete to Rowe. Ooh, it's going to be really close. He's still on his feet.
Oh, he's fighting for the yardage.
It's going to be really close. I think he's a yard short, though.
Lost his helmet.
And there was maybe a little extracurricular activity at the same time. They're going to mark it at the 33.
And that was Rowe, correct?
It was Rowe on the catch.
Yeah, he's a fiery guy.
I believe it's going to come up, and they will be a yard short.
Looks to be just short of the first down. Brings up fourth down.
So fourth down, and West Stanley is going to go for it. Fourth and 1 here. West Stanley may be trying to draw North off.
Yeah, this is a very dangerous play. Yeah, I think they might have got him. I think they got him. I think number 77 jumped.
Yeah, it was Austin Parker, and there was someone, I think it was also to his right, might have been C.J. Clark, might have been even someone else, but it was.
And that's a first down.
And that's a first down.
Clock continuing to run with 9:13 to go here in the second quarter.
19-7, Comets leading. Colts drive stays alive on fourth down, drawing North Stanley offsides. Jackson now tries to cut to the middle. Ooh, a late block.
Number 76
Andrew,
in on the tackle.
Andrew Page indeed. They're going to give him almost 3 yards. It'll bring up second and around 7. Clock continuing to run, 8:40 left in the first half. Wide receivers to either side of the field once again. Going to be Jackson. Oh, tries to avoid early contact, but cannot.
Jackson around the left side for the Colts.
Might have been number 4, Antoine Sloan, but I couldn't really see. He'll lose 3 yards back to the 36.
I think it was Wolford, number 21, that finished him off.
21 is Taylor Chandler. West Stanley, North Stanley. This is the North Stanley roster.
No, I'm trying
this
to read
the West Stanley roster.
I can't see that far. I'm trying to.
Three wide receivers on the near side, third and 11, maybe setting up a wide receiver screen. Instead, Nate Taylor was wide open in the middle. Instead, he throws a double coverage, and what a catch by Rowe. Rowe, 25, down to the 23.
Amazing, amazing catch.
He had
amazing
double
throw,
coverage.
Amazing catch.
And Nate Taylor was wide open in the middle of the field, and I was just about a half second away from saying that it was a, you know, it still probably would have been a better choice to throw to the open receiver, but Rowe came up with a tremendous catch in traffic.
I'm going to have to time that where we're at because I want to put that on the highlight reel.
That was a beautiful pitch and catch between Boone and Rowe.
I think we'll use that one for our new opening credits.
Oh, absolutely. No doubt about it. Beautiful catch. First and 10 for the Colts now.
Exactly what they needed right now.
Absolutely what they needed and right when they needed it. Three wide receivers to the far side this time. Instead is Jackson, and he goes nowhere. A host of several Comets. Also, number 32 was in there, Drew Little. And I think might have been 52, the big fella, C.J. Clark, all 6'2", 265 of him.
Comets defense has been able to contain Mr. Jackson here so far.
The loss is back to the 27. So we're going to take a quick timeout, though. I believe we have another timeout on the field. 6:51 left, second quarter. North Stanley 19, West Stanley 7. Second and 13. Now Boone over the middle, incomplete. Oh, and a late hit from C.J. Clark. The Colt fans screaming for a flag. None forthcoming. The pass was intended for Balcom over the middle, but I think what the fans are complaining about the most is the contact between Balcom and Clark. And it was one of those, it may have looked worse than it was, but a lot of times penalties get called more about how a penalty looks as opposed to what it really was. You could say that for holding for most of the time. So third down and 13 now for the Colts. They need to get to the 17-yard line. Boone looking to throw far side. And it is picked off. 28, Austin Sides.
Yeah, that's a heartbreaker for the Colts here.
The second turnover of the game. Six minutes, 42 seconds left. The drive stalls. The second turnover of this game by West Stanley ends a long drive. And the Comets have one timeout left and 6 minutes and 42 seconds left, and they may be one player short. They need a fullback is what they're looking
number
for.
Number 30's trotting
Mike
on
Peoples,
the field.
Mike Peoples scored a touchdown earlier.
It's going to be a delay
and
game.
And North Stanley's going to have to call their final timeout, and we will take one as well and be right back. 6:42 left, second quarter. North Stanley gets the turnover and leads 19-7. Three rushing touchdowns in the game. Williams now cuts across the middle. He just carries two and three tacklers with him just about every time.
He is a workhorse.
Comet up the middle, bring up second and four for the Comets.
Gain of about five will bring up second down and we'll make it second down and four.
That's why I'm watching Antonio through youth football up to now, watched him all these years. You know, he's, what, 5'9", 5'10", now? What's his weight?
He's up to 5'11", 217 pounds now. It's the up back this time, Peoples, and he rumbles for a first down over the 25.
Number 30, Mike Peoples, up the middle for the Comets, and that'll be good enough for a Comet. First down.
Right now, North Stanley's offense is getting just about anything they want.
I would not be surprised to see Noah's been pretty confident in the air. That he might
the short passing game has worked, and when you have a running back like Williams, obviously he can break one just about any time. A critical turnover by Wes Stanley led to North's last touchdown. We'll see what this turnover does. Now Crisco throwing over the middle, and it's just through the hands of number 80 Jordan Howard.
Just a little bit too much mustard on that.
We'll bring up second down and 10. But if you notice, most of the passing that Crisco has done so far in this game have been really short passes or some sort of a timing pattern. He's 4 of 11 right now for 55 yards. On the other side, Boone is 3 of 7 for 42 yards, but he has that interception. Comets lead 19-7, 5:28, clock stopped. With 5:28 left in the second. Almost a run and shoot offense that North Stanley is running. Williams again, off tackle, look out. 45, look at the speed of Antonio Williams. Bye-bye. Touchdown, North Stanley Comets. And that's 63 yards.
He's keeping on running. I think he's going to run through the fence.
Excuse me, it's longer than that.
Just another day at the office, Charles.
Right now, he's the CEO of that office. Late substitution. I don't think they have a... I don't know what's going on here. They don't have a timeout. There are no timeouts left. Tyler Billingsley is still on the...
What's going on here?
They didn't have a holder or a kicker.
You might need that.
They're going to need to run, get this play in very quickly. They're
going to get a delay.
They have five. I'll be very surprised if they get this one snapped in time. They just barely do, and the extra point is good. 5:17 left. In the second quarter, 26-7, North Stanley over West Stanley. 228. Can anybody tell me what that number is? That's the number of yards Antonio Williams has in this game on 10 carries.
Unbelievable. 5:17 left in the second.
And
the
three
second,
touchdowns
first half
as
here.
Well. Billingsley with a kick. Going to be taken by Izaguirre at around the 5 or 10-yard line. Trying to follow his blockers. Oh, he's got a hole. 35-40. One man to beat. He's got the kicker in front of him as well. 40. Oh, he puts on the brakes. Still on his feet. And down
nice
around the
move.
36.
Nice move.
And if the Colts needed a lift, Izaguirre may have just given it to him.
I'm telling you, last week, he was a star last week. You know, he's been pretty quiet here this first half, but that's what Izaguirre can do.
The ball is marked at the North Stanley 38. A big return of nearly 50 yards. Three wide receivers this time, two to the far side. Colts trailing 26-7, trying to find some offense. And a turnover last time. Now Boone over the middle. It's complete to Rowe. Rowe off to the right. And now we'll get corralled by three or four different Comets around the 24, but he's got a first down. I think, Brian, I have to say that both teams are very respectful of the other team's pass rush, because right now, only a couple of times in this game have I seen either quarterback really drop back for a pass. All you see is about a three-step drop and boom, get rid of the football. It's all short passes right now. First and 10 for the Colts now. Down to the Comet 23, yep. A quick screen pass to Rowe. going to get pushed out of bounds, or he gets hit hard. No flag forthcoming. He was already out of bounds.
Coach Mormon is incensed.
And he is upset, and I honestly can't say that I blame him.
That kind of looked like a late hit.
Pass is good to the – it was only a gain of about 3 yards to bring up second and seven, but more importantly is the cumulative effect of the kinds of shots like that on Taylen Rowe – or Taylen Rowe, excuse me. See, at Pfeiffer, we had a Rowe Hall. That's why it's so hard for me to say Rowe. Jackson now cuts up the middle. Oh, he gets upended by C.J.
Is that C.J. Harris?
Yeah.
Say, no Mr. Jackson, not in my house.
Well, he got 5 yards in his house, but he paid for every one of those.
And now brings number 76 coming out.
Third and two. And as you say, Andrew Page coming out. Three wide receivers this time on second down, and it should be third down, actually. Jackson trying to turn the corner, cannot.
Seemed to he lost his footing on the grass there. He couldn't quite get his footing right.
Actually, he'll probably lose a yard to the 16.
Yeah, I think the field worked against him on that one.
Now the field, it says first down. But I have to tell you, I think that it's fourth down. It says third down, but I think it's fourth down. Because I had Christian Boom with the screen pass, unless that was a screen pass for a first down.
Well, the board says first down.
That's third and three now. Pass is complete to Rowe. He's got it the middle of the field and a touchdown. West Stanley Colts.
Those short passes you were talking about, Charles, it's working for him.
A 16-yard touchdown pass. Well, I was actually talking about the short passing game of, well, both teams are really going for that. 3 minutes, 21 seconds. It's 26-13. Green for the point after. Oh, it bounces the snap to him, but a beautiful kick. And it is good. 3:21 left, second quarter. Comets 26, Colts 13. So a 16-yard touchdown pass from Christian Boone to Taylen Rowe. Colts push one in. Excuse me, it's actually 26-14. Logan Green for the kickoff. Long kick is going to be taken right at the goal line by Sloan, I believe, and Sloan is going to get buried by Edwards and three others, and a penalty marker down as well.
Oh, check that penalty. What is that penalty,
I did not
Charles?
See the penalty. The flag is sitting at the 29. It's behind the play. Let's see what it is. Ball was resting at about the 16. It's against North Stanley. It's a holding call. So if it's marked from the 14, it'll be down half the distance to the goal to the 7. Bless you.
Thank you.
So it'll be first and 10 from about the 7. Comets have 3 minutes, 15 seconds left there. They do not have a timeout. Clock will stop to move the chains on first downs. But 3:15 is an eternity when you have someone that is averaging well over 12 yards. I think it's 12.7 yards per carry in the person of Antonio Williams.
And he's the man to get you out of trouble here.
And it's Williams off the right side, now cuts it back up the middle, and he's going to go down across the 20 and around the 23. Clock will stop to move the chains.
Oh, a little, like I say, a little extracurricular activity down there.
There was a lot riding on this game. No doubt about it.
Yeah, you know, Wes Stanley wants that Stanley Cup.
Here goes Williams again off the right side. Another first down, down around the 39. And they're moving very quickly, a gain of 16 and a first down.
And Noah going to the air here. Let's see, he's in trouble. And he throws it away.
Bring up second down and 10. Clock stop with 2 minutes and 50 seconds left. Antonio Williams now 12 carries for 260 yards. He's averaging, ready for this number, 21.7 per carry.
That's insane.
Unbelievable numbers. Gets it off the right side this time. Ooh, he is hit hard at the line of scrimmage. This time he does not go anywhere, maybe a couple of yards. I believe that was Mr. Connor Edwards leading the charge again.
Antonio was a little slow getting up.
Antonio took a wallop on that particular play.
And he has been over on the far side of the field.
May have gotten the wind knocked out of him. And it is Antonio that's down.
Yeah. I believe you're right. I think he got the wind knocked out of him. Which, if you've ever had that happen to you, it'll put you out for a little while.
He may even be cramping a little bit.
Injury timeout.
Oh, here he comes.
Yeah, I may have just gotten shaken up momentarily. He will have to come out of the game for the next play.
I think he'd have to get run over by a Mack truck before he comes out of a game.
Well, he is definitely a tough customer, no doubt about it. He's readjusting. It looks like the pad on his left knee might have taken kind of a shot there.
Yeah, it looks like he's trying to get his wind back.
So this sets up more of a passing down, and you wonder how much pressure Wes Stanley will bring on this play. Third down and 8 now, ball resting at the 41. They need to get to just about near the midfield stripe. A little short pass, and it is before we have any of that.
Yeah, blown dead.
I think North Stanley may have moved too quickly, may have a false start. And that's what it is. So when you have to come set for 1 second before
I'm just helping.
Oh boy. Boy, if there was a camera for what goes on in press boxes, that's all I'm gonna say. Third down and 13, and now number 20 is Cameron Davis.
Yeah, nice little pickup.
And Davis will get down to the 40, maybe the 41, but well short. And I believe Williams is asking if North Stanley is going to go for it. And at the 41, I honestly, you would think more of a punting situation. And indeed, there goes C.J. Harris.
Yeah. And the clock is continuing to run with 1:36 left in this first half.
North Stanley maybe got to play a little field position game here and give Williams a little rest. Sounds like we're getting B-29s going ahead overhead. I'm not sure what that was.
We have a flag on the field.
And North Stanley may have taken too much time, and they did.
Yep. I think the Comets are trying to end this half as quickly as possible.
No doubt about it. The clock will stop now on that penalty. A minute 20. Izaguirre is going to be standing now. Well, they brought him in expecting a short punt. CJ just a booming kick. It's going to take a sort of a neutral bounce at the 29. I'm not sure exactly why Izaguirre moved up.
I know he moved up.
He moved up 20,
he was
20 yards, and
it
just
kick.
Had no shot at any kind of return.
Colts will take over on offense just inside the 30-yard line. First and 10.
Clock stopped now with a minute 13. Nobody has any timeouts left.
Well, with a minute 13 to go, what would you be your strategy for the Colts right now? Play it safe or be aggressive?
I think if you've got Wes Stanley, we'll get the football to start the second half. I don't think
maybe a little conservative.
Yeah, I would take a shot here or two just to see what happens.
That's what they're doing.
Goes up for Nate Taylor, and it is picked off through the legs. What a play by number 28, Austin Sides. He was bobbling the football and then caught it between his legs.
That's
I think
amazing.
He almost trapped it with his thighs.
I thought,
that's an amazing play.
Is that a catch?
That's the third interception of the game and the second for that young man.
I wish I would have been a little bit closer in on that, Charles. That was amazing.
An amazing play.
Well, that changes the complexion of the game right here.
With a minute, 3 seconds left, still nobody has any timeouts, but let's see if Antonio will get a carry here. He is in the game. He's been the workhorse so far in this first quarter, first half, 13 carries, 162 yards. Instead, Crisco's going to try to throw the football, looking to the far sidelines, complete to Reynolds. Reynolds is knocked out of bounds. It will stop the clock.
And that is a completion.
It is a completion, and the defensive back actually did him a favor there.
Yeah, about 4 yards shy of the first down.
Looking to throw again, and this time it's batted down. Oh, hit the back of a defensive lineman. Falls incomplete. It brings up third down. Clock stop with 58.7 seconds left. So it's going to be third down and about four. Actually, the tackle, what I was going to say, is the defensive back for Wes Stanley did North a favor by knocking him out of bounds instead of holding. If he would have stopped his forward progress inbounds, the clock would have kept running. Mm-hmm. Now Crisco looking for a screen pass to Williams. He's got it. First down and way more.
Pass, he did not get out of bounds.
The clock will stop to move the chains, though. They'll mark the ball.
That's right, with 53 seconds left.
Mark the ball at the 37 of Wes Stanley. It's a first down.
That's plenty of time for Antonio Williams and company.
Clock will stop to move the chains, and now we'll start again. And a little quick pass to the slot receiver, complete 25, and he's got another first down.
81, Wes Reynolds with the catch for the Comets.
And North Stanley is moving the football down the field. A 12-yard gain that time. Yeah. Clock stops again, 45.1 left.
Nice catch by Mr. Reynolds.
And now Crisco again to throw. Looking to the far sideline, and it's complete to Reynolds. Reynolds, he stays in bounds instead. He's still on his feet. And oh, wow, does he get hit hard at the 14.
And bounces right back up.
Holy Toledo, did he take a wallop. But it's good enough for a first down. I thought he made a mistake, because if he hadn't got the first down, the clock would have kept running.
Well, now it's running now with 30 seconds.
Now 30 seconds left. Crisco looking again over the middle, and it is incomplete, and a dangerous tipped pass.
Number 25 could have intercepted that very easily.
Yeah, Lawson-Udy had a shot at it. Even Izaguirre was sort of in the neighborhood as well. And to bring up second down. What a finish to this. Wes Stanley, instead of running the clock out, tried to make something happen. And instead, Austin Sides with one of the greatest interceptions I've ever seen, bobbling the football, then caught it between his thighs, and then picked it up and actually ran a couple of yards. 26-14, 25.5 left in this first half. Second and 10 for the Comets now at the Colt 14. Looking at the far sideline, it's complete to Reynolds. Oh, he's hit hard out of bounds.
Oh, that should be a penalty, and the flag is coming, and it is. Come out.
He's out of bounds to stop the clock, but it'll make it half the distance to the goal after that penalty. The ball is resting at about the 5-yard line.
So this is going to put him, about the 3?
About the 3, actually.
About the 3.
They're marking it. It looks like it was about the 5-yard line. It actually would have been short of the first down, but the penalty is half the distance to the goal when you get that close down.
I see they're marking it off, and I think it is about the 3-yard line.
First and goal now from the 3. Clock is stopped with 21.4 seconds left. North Stanley has at least maybe 2 chances if they want to put the football through the air.
Oh, yeah, I see a good 2 plays coming out of this.
4 wide once again. It's going to be a keeper by Crisco, and Crisco's in trouble, and he goes down in the hands of Cameron Brown, and now the Comets have to scramble.
They better hurry to get a playoff. They better hurry, spike it.
I think they might just need to spike the football.
But yeah, you better do it.
No, he's going to try to. And now we have a penalty with 5.5 seconds left. It's going to be a false start against North. If I'm not mistaken, the clock should run as the second the ball is put ready for play.
Yeah, looks like this is going to be the last play of the first half, Charles.
Clock now running, 5, 4, 3. Crisco throws to the end zone, looking for Reynolds. He's got it for a touchdown, but hold the phone.
He clearly pushed off.
He pushed off the West Stanley DB with both
hold
hands.
The phones,
and
hold
then
the
just
phone.
Caught the ball like, hello, I've got the ball. It's a touchdown. No. And the game, the half can end, will end on the offensive penalty. If this is the call that I believe it is.
I think you're right. That's what the official looks. Indicated.
Pass interference against North Stanley, and that will be the end of the first half. We'll be back with a halftime show and stats and more with that halftime score. North Stanley 26, West Stanley 14 on Stanley County Monday Night Football.
Yeah.
So we were told there's actually 1 second left. My apologies. So North Stanley actually gets one more shot at it from the 29. The ball is marked at the 28-yard line. Still waiting. They have 1 second to try to run this, and now I think we're getting...
The officials are discussing this.
I think we're getting a discussion about that because...
Now they're going to run it. One last play, it looks like.
So one last play in this game. Crisco going to throw a screen pass, and it's blocked down. And West Stanley gets a momentum play going into the locker room. Now it really is the end of the first half.
Now it is the end of the first half, ladies and gentlemen.
26-14, North Stanley over West Stanley. We'll be back on Stanley County Monday Night Football. Patriotic song I could find on my computer. It's the Marine hymn, as we see, never forget. And 9/11, we never will forget. Forget the sacrifices that people made that day. And we thank you for those. And the key is we must always stay vigilant. And I will now get off my
absolutely.
Soapbox. All right, Brian, we're going to take a look at some halftime stats. Give me just a second here trying to get halftime stats for you. Antonio Williams, 13 carries, 262 yards, three touchdowns. As a team, North Stanley, 22 carries, 272 net yards. For West Stanley, 17 carries, 89 net yards, averaging 5.2 yards a carry, which is
very
not bad. Christian Boone is 6 of 11 for 76 yards, one touchdown but two interceptions. Noah Crisco, 9 of 20 for 107 yards. Team stats, penalties, 7 penalties, 44 yards against West Stanley, 8 penalties, 60 yards against North Stanley. So a lot of penalties in this game. One fumble lost in this game was West Stanley, and that came back to haunt them. So while we have a quick second, let's also run down the scoring summary. Antonio Williams, 50 seconds into this game, broke off an 84-yard touchdown run. West Stanley immediately answered with Malik Jackson for a 41-yard touchdown run. The kick was good, and West Stanley led 7-6, and then the Comets scored three straight touchdowns. Mike Peoples with a 3-yard touchdown run, Antonio Williams for a 15 yards, and then later for 74 yards. And just before the half, Christian Boone finished off a drive to Taylor Rowe with a 16-yard touchdown pass, and that has us where we're at right now, 26-14.
It's been an exciting game, Charles, and glad to be here at RN Jeffries Stadium on a beautiful, rather humid night, but it's not too hot.
It's quite humid, but also, Brian, I have to say this as well. It's going to be interesting to see what adjustments the teams have made in this first half.
Yeah, I mean, the score, 26-14, I mean, it's anybody's ball game right now.
Well, and also, neither defense has shut down the other team's offense particularly.
I'm curious to see who breaks away first, Malik or Antonio. And we're just about ready to kick this off.
Well, both teams' fans are out in full force. A lot of people at tonight's game. The Comet crazies are out.
They are.
The Colt crazies are making noise, doing push-ups.
I mean, they're lying around the track even.
There are people everywhere at this game. All right, here we go. Second half about to get underway. Tyler Billingsley will kick off. End over end kick. Going to drive Rowe back to the 3-yard line. 5-10. 15-20. Trying to find a lane, and he does momentarily. And then runs out of real estate at the 33.
Ball be spotted around the 33-yard line. Colts will take over. First and 10.
You know, one thing I've noticed, Brian, about kickoff returns tonight for West Stanley is that they've tried to follow blockers, but they get kind of caught right in the middle of the field there. They're not getting wide enough. The blockers don't seem to be getting wide enough. They're kind of getting close to the, I'm sorry, I just bumped the camera.
That's okay.
Well, I'm Italian. I talk with my hands. What do you want from me?
Dock your pay.
What are you talking about? I talk with my hands. And the kickoff return is not getting wide enough. First and 10 now. Izaguirre in motion. Rowe, a quarterback. And he'll get a few yards.
And 33 in the tackle.
Gain of about 5. We'll bring up second down and 5. We talk often about how missed extra points can come back to haunt teams. North Stanley has missed 2 in this game. And a 12-point lead is not the most secure lead. Izaguirre now around the side, first down and more. And when you've got athletes like Izaguirre, West Stanley is not out of this game by a long shot.
Chandler with the tackle for the Comets.
Into Comet territory to the 45. And a first down.
Yeah, West Stanley looking pretty good coming out of the gate.
17 yards that time for Izaguirre. Offense is really moving down the field with Rowe at quarterback. Now Rowe off the right side. C.J. Harris gets him after maybe 2 yards. They'll bring up second and 8.
C.J. gave a good hit to C.J. Clark there, his teammate.
Both teams really piling up the offense and averaging well over, each team is averaging well over 5-6 yards a play. This time Jackson gets hit by the counterpart 33, Will Moore.
Can I say a plethora?
A plethora.
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 The password is plethora. Yes, plethora of comments.
Thank you for correcting my English, which stinks.
So they'll give him, well, really no gain on the play. It'll bring up third down now and 8. They've got to get to just past the 35, around the 34, 2 minutes into this third quarter. Colts trailing 26-14. Boone to throw. He drops the football.
Fumble on the play, but I think he recovered.
He did recover it. The H-back Cameron Brown was right there as well, but it'll bring up a punting situation. It didn't look like he just, it just like he, it could just slipped out of his hands. Fourth down and about 13 now. Green to punt this one. A low kick. Oh, it's going to take a beautiful bounce for the Colts and roll dead at the 2-yard line.
Great job by Mr. Green.
They could not have rolled the ball there better.
Bubba West Stanley. Ball spotted inside the 5. Comets will take over. First and 10.
With 9 minutes and 10 seconds left in the third quarter, Comets in the shadow of their own end zone.
Logan Green, what is it? He's a junior?
Logan Green is a senior.
Senior. I wonder if any colleges will be looking at this kid.
He's definitely got the leg to be able to kick in college. No question about it. I formation this time on first and 10. Vince Williams cuts up the middle. Spin move and still going.
I love that spin move he makes.
Spinorama, if you will. Gains 8 on the play, brings up 2nd and 2.
We got
and now he's
here.
Down, and it's Williams.
He's grabbing his leg.
He's in a lot of pain. He's grabbing at his left leg again. He's grabbing at his left leg. I can't see if it's maybe cramping again or possibly a lower leg injury. It looks like they're looking at the left ankle, possibly.
Well, they seem to be massaging the outside of the calf, which if you get a cramp on the outside of your calf, it's a lot more painful than the inside.
Than the inside, harder, yes, absolutely.
Harder to relieve that pain.
Absolutely.
But, oh, he is reeling here. But he's going to try to get up. Let's see.
They're going to.
You got to work it out. Got to work it out.
Nope. All right, let's take a quick timeout, Brian, and we'll be right back. Well, Antonio Williams coming off the field under his own power, which is a good sign.
He was down for a while, Charles. He had major leg cramp. I was a little worried there that I'm glad it's not a knee or anything.
Or anything, yeah.
Yeah. Oh. And now back to the action.
Oh, thank you. I'm only trying to tweet, keep stats, and do about 10 different other things over here.
So we're multitasking up here, folks.
So 2nd and 2 this time. The give is to Brown, and he goes down for a loss. Is Aguera might have led the charge that time.
Yeah, number 3.
And Colt
tackle.
Oh, excuse me, Cameron Brown. Brings up 3rd down now at about 4. Clock running 8:18 left, third quarter. I mean, you can't see this on camera, but Williams is trying to work out that cramp in his foot. I formation this time on 3rd down. trying to cut to the outside. Too much penetration by the West defense. And it's going to bring up fourth down. He lost two more yards.
Brings up about fourth and seven.
So the Comets are going to have to punt the football away. And
that should give West a very, very decent field position.
CJ is going to have to – CJ Harris is the punter. He's going to have to
put a lot of leg into this.
Do some work here to get the ball out of the end zone. I wonder how much pressure West Stanley will bring. Gets it away, high end over end kick. Izaguirre wants to try to return it. He is not going to. Actually takes a West Stanley bounce and rolls dead at the Comet 43.
Good job, Mr. Harris.
It's a 37-yard punt. And the ball changes hands now. 7 minutes, 7 seconds left in the third. Three wide receivers this time for West Stanley, two to the far side. Jackson with a fake. No, it's a pass looking for Rowe. Rowe incomplete. It was covered that time by Landon Williams.
Yeah, Rowe was trying to do an acrobatic one-arm grab.
Yeah, well, the pass was, I think, was just maybe slightly behind him. Brings up second down and 10 now. It'll be Jackson, tries to turn the corner, does momentarily, not much there, maybe a yard.
33, Jackson around the
way out of bounds there.
They're going to give him maybe, like I said, maybe a yard. Only bring up third now and 9. Check on Jackson's stats.
And Coach Mormon trying to get his kids going here.
Jackson now 18 carries for 87 yards. He's gaining, averaging a healthy 4.8 yards per carry. That's what you really want. But West Stanley now, oh, it's third and 10. They're going to give him no gain on that last play. They'll give to Jackson. Got blockers in front of him. Still on his feet, 35, look out, 30, still going, and he's got a first down at the 26.
Charles, how did he get out of trouble like that? I thought he was down 10 yards.
Just nobody wrapped up, they just didn't wrap up a tackle on him, and he just kept the legs going.
Unbelievable player.
And first and 10 now at the Comet, 26, clock running, 6:23 left, third quarter. Colts trailing 26-14 and knocking on the door. Boone fakes a pass and now tries to run with it. Nice open field tackle that time by Will Moore. And he loses 3 yards on the play. It'll bring up second down and 13. And West Stanley seemed to be trying to up the tempo a little bit. Looks like they're trying to run no huddle. Looking to pass once again. Fires to the far sideline. And it's caught in for a touchdown.
Unbelievable.
West Stanley Colts. It was tipped by number 20, Cameron Davis. And Rowe found a way to bring that one in.
Unbelievable. Unbelievable. I think Mr. Rose is still in the making.
What a huge turning point in this game. Winning a field position battle and then... I think that's twice we've seen Rowe on the tip drill this season doing that. A 29-yard touchdown pass.
Another highlight reel.
Green for the point after now.
And it doesn't get much better than that.
That kick is good. 5:35 left. In the third quarter, North Stanley 26, West Stanley 21.
And we got a game here, folks. Don't go away.
So So for the second time tonight, Christian Boone and Taylen Rowe have connected for a touchdown pass.
They are
26,
they are a tandem team.
21. What a ball game we've got tonight.
West Stanley definitely made some adjustments.
And they went to the pass and got a caught a break really on a tip play, and that's why you run those tip drills in practice. Green now, this is going to be a shorter kickoff taken at about the 6-yard line. That's LJ Rush, and Rush goes down hard at the 25.
Commons will take over on offense, first and 10.
So they're going to mark the ball at the 21. But the important question here is...
Ladies and gentlemen, get your raffle tickets out. It is time for the draw winning number for the 50-50 raffle.
The question here is Antonio back in the game? Yes, he is.
4-3-3-5-0-3.
Wide receivers this time, first and 10. And now we have a timeout, North Stanley. And we'll take one as well. 5:29 left in the third. Back on Stanley County, Monday Night Football. First and 10 for the Comets now. From the 21, it's going to be Williams off the left side, and he is stopped cold.
I think it was number 50.
Check that. I'm sorry, LJ Chambers. Along with, I think, 52 Salazar possibly as well, Christian Salazar. The loss is about 2 yards back to the 19, brings up second down and 12. Clock running, 5:11 left, third quarter. North Stanley leading West Stanley, 26-21. The Stanley Cup up for grabs tonight. West Stanley can win it with a victory. North Stanley can dash West Stanley's hopes and keep their own alive. Williams now keeping the, look at him keep the legs moving. And a late flag comes in. Oh, that may be against West Stanley for a late hit of some sort. Ball is resting at the 28. Let's see what the penalty is.
Well, they're discussing it here.
It may go against North for a hold, too. It is a dead ball foul. Unsportsmanlike conduct against West Stanley and unsportsmanlike against the offset, and the run never happened. So they move
the ball. Let's do that again.
They'll have to move the ball back to where the original line of scrimmage was with the and around the 23. I don't know why they're... Oh, it was after the play. I understand. So the run will count, and it'll bring up third down now at about 5. Clock still running, 4:45. I don't know if the clock ever stopped. Hard count. Ooh, West Stanley flinched, but did not go. Williams, 35. Look out! He's got no one to beat. He's gone. Isaguirre is trying to catch him, but oh, he's trying to catch him at the very end. Just at the very last
second. Oh, he slowed up there.
Williams slowed up. Touchdown, North Stanley Comets, and he almost, Isaguirre almost caught him.
And Williams is having to
take
a little sit down there.
There are no flags on the field. Well, when you run 82 yards, I think you're allowed to have
leg cramps. Yeah, I think so. I think you're allowed.
Matter of fact, he is still.
It's like, get him.
Down in the end zone. Now he's coming off. Now coming off the field. His numbers are astronomical now after that run.
I want to hear this.
He has 349 net yards on 17 carries. Oh, the extra point is no good. It hit the right upright.
That is three times.
That's three missed extra points.
Is no good, but your score, Comets 32, Colts 21.
Well, we'll take a break right now, ladies and gentlemen, and that's Comets 32 and the Colts 21. We'll be right back after this.
Antonio Williams now with 17 carries, 349 net yards by my count.
Don't forget next game to get your 50-50 raffle.
He's just blowing up the record books, isn't he?
He's going, I think he's very close to his own record that he just set a couple of weeks ago at Sun Valley.
Which was...
I don't remember exactly off the top of my head, sorry. End over end kick going to be taken by Rowe at the 8-yard line. Trying to find room to the outside, and he does. Nice return this time as he's, whoa, is he knocked out of bounds hard by number 21, Taylor Chandler.
Twice he's got knocked out of bounds hard.
Very hard that time. Returns a solid one to the 40-yard line. The Comets lead by 11. Colts had a solid scoring drive their last time on the field. Three wide receivers this time on first and 10. It's going to be Jackson coming off the left side. Oh, he's got blockers in front of him. 45, 50, got a first down. 40, still on his feet. He's got a couple men to beat. Finally gets knocked out of bounds by C.J. Clark.
Yeah, he
or
just
C.J. Harris
out of bounds.
At the 28. He got actually sort of ushered out of bounds, if you will.
Gently nudged out of bounds.
What a football game this has been tonight.
I'm telling you, it's been exciting, folks.
And we have seen some tremendous running plays in this game. Obviously, Williams has been on fire, but give credit to Malik Jackson. He over 100 yards with that gain. Now 25,
here he goes 20, again.
Still on his feet, trying to find some room, stays in bounds instead of going out of bounds, and is folded like a piece of origami at the 15. Can I at least say the word first?
No, let's bring back
origami,
Ray Kazaa there.
Oh, yes, Ray Kazaa. Oh, big play, Ray.
Big play, Ray.
Gain of 12 that time at a first down.
Yeah, Malik Jackson's on fire, but let's don't forget honorable mention Mr. Rowe. I mean,
21,
really been...
true, 21 carries, 148 yards. It's Izaguirre this time, still on his feet. Big hole that time off the right side across the 10, down to around the 6. He's close to a first. I think he might just be a little short. They're going to mark him short at around just outside the 6. Izaguirre, no gain that time. It'll bring up third down and 1. West Stanley can get a first down before they get in the end zone. Working without a huddle. Clock continuing to run, 3:09 left third quarter. Comets lead 32-21, the Colts are threatening again. Izaguirre off the left side, and this time C.J. Harris says no at the 12.
Oh, he's C.J.'s, he's on the ground, he's hurt.
And he's grabbing his
left,
he's grabbing his ankle and the lower part of his left. And he is down, and this may be a serious injury. We're not entirely sure right now.
Yeah, that's Mr. Harris down there, and it looks like this isn't cramps. He was grabbing that ankle pretty hard.
Loss of 5 on the play. It'll bring up an interesting fourth down play once we get back to football. But North Stanley's attentions right now obviously are on the health of their – one of their stalwarts on defense and their punter, C.J. Harris.
Yeah. They can't really afford to lose him. Oh, he is in pain.
The 5'11", 240-pound senior. All right, folks, we're going to take a quick break, and we'll be right back when we have a little more information.
Well, let's stay with the play.
Oh, let's stay with it. He's coming off the field. Okay.
Yeah. He hopped up and he's back maybe just action here.
Maybe just cramps in that case. And
he's limping a little bit.
Gimpy on the ankle, maybe.
Yeah, so this probably tweaked it a little bit.
So interesting play here, fourth down and six.
That was amazing. I mean, he was flat on his back in pain.
It just got right up. At the 11-yard line, 2:50 left third quarter, as you can see in the upper left part of your screen. Colts got a chance to actually go to the sideline and discuss the play. Fourth down and six from the Comet 11. It's going to be Jackson off the right side. He's got blocks in front of him. Close to the end zone. Still driving. He's in. Touchdown. West Stanley Colts.
The Colts refuse to go quietly into the good night.
They're not going into that good night at all. And with 2 minutes, 36 seconds. Actually, you wonder if West Stanley might think about trying to go for two here, because it's actually 32-27, and a two-point conversion would actually make it a three-point game, which means you could tie with a field goal if that would be the scenario. Point. But again, they're not really trying to chase points, I guess. They're just trying to stay solid with what they're doing. There are times, though, when it is advantageous to go for two. But nonetheless, the extra point is good. 32-28. North Stanley still leads West Stanley. 2:36 left, third quarter. We'll be back. So Malik Jackson with a touchdown run. Extra point is good, and the Colts continue to fight in this game. They led 7-6 early and have not led since, but they have matched North Stanley touchdown for touchdown. With 2:36 left in the third. Both teams, I think, are paying a heavy price for this game. You're starting to see guys getting up a little more slowly. Fatigue really is starting to set in on both sides of the field.
It's not that hot.
It's not hot particularly, but it's
humidity, and that's a.
It's humid.
You know, the cramps are coming into play now.
Low end over end kick, but before that, we have a penalty, and I believe West Stanley was offsides.
All right, let's try this again.
Eight penalties, 49 yards against West Stanley. Eight penalties, 60 yards against North Stanley. North has not had a penalty yet in this second half.
And I'm sure they'd like to keep it that way.
No question. All right, Logan Green to put it in the air again. Much better long end over end kick taken at the 10-yard line up the sideline, 20. And oh, he runs into a
brick wall.
A brick wall with the name of Connor Edwards at the 27. I believe we call it arrested momentum.
We need to come up with a good nickname for him. Mr. Brick House.
he dropped the hammer on him right there.
That's twice tonight he's done that.
Absolutely. Well, several times, actually. He's an integral party. Coach Mormon calls him the quarterback of the West Stanley defense, Connor Edwards.
Absolutely.
Williams is back in the backfield. First and 10, four wide this time. West Stanley may try to bring more pressure here. Williams now straight up the middle. He'll push the pile forward about 4 yards. It'll bring up second down and six.
Gain of about five on the play. Brings up second and five.
Second and five now. We haven't seen as much of the short passing game. This time it's a give to number 20, Cameron Davis. And Davis still on his feet. Great job to stay on his feet. But he's going to go down for a loss in the hands of Nate Taylor. A five-yard loss back to the 30. Now to bring up third down and 10. You have to give West Stanley's defense credit in this third quarter. They did allow Williams to get through them for a touchdown, but they have done a pretty good job containing North Stanley's offense somewhat in this quarter. Crisco now, the quick pass is complete, but very little gain on the play. It was complete to Burleson. Nice play by Rowe on the outside with a tackle.
Yeah, Burleson had nowhere to run.
And it's another punting situation.
And 48 seconds left to go in this third quarter. Clock continues to run.
West Stanley will get the football in fairly decent position with about 16 seconds left in this third quarter. Crisco is back out to punt. He came off the field earlier with possibly cramps. Let's see this kick. An end-over-end kick is going to hit a little short of Izaguirre.
Nice punt.
And roll dead around the Colt 19.
With a nice punt by number 41, C.J. Harris. Ball spotted around the 19-yard line. Colts will take over on offense. First and 10.
And a half seconds left in the fourth. Colts have three timeouts remaining in an entire fourth quarter.
And North Stanley has two, I believe.
And those three missed extra points mean that West Stanley, with a touchdown, could take the lead as opposed to just possibly of tying the game.
Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to remind you the concession stand now has Zaxby's and Nibblers. Get your Zaxby's in the concession stand today.
And now I believe West Stanley has called timeout. We'll take one as well. 16 and a half seconds left in the third quarter. So we have about one play left in this third quarter. The Comets leading the West Stanley Colts 32 to 28. 16 and a half seconds left in the third. Colts calling a timeout. They have, each team now has two remaining. Rowe is in at quarterback. We'll fake the give, and now Jax has it. Slips one tackle, slips another tackle. Oh, ball's loose, and North Stanley has it.
Number 33.
And number 33 recovers it. Will Moore with the fumble recovery. And that's another turnover. After about an 8-yard gain, Jackson fumbles the football, and Will Moore comes up with it. And with 10.7 seconds left, the second fumble of this game and third turnover.
I have the momentum changes here. Momentum,
it may be a big field position change, if nothing else. Crisco now going to throw, complete to Earl Reynolds, dropped it. And it'll bring up second down.
With
the clock never, I don't think the clock ever moved.
Let's see, 10.1 seconds left. Charles, you're probably looking at maybe one play left.
There's only about 6 seconds left in this game anyway, but the clock never moved on that play. It'll bring up second down and 10. It just gives the Comets a few extra seconds in this half. Williams off the right side. Hits, guess who? Connor Edwards right at the 25, only a 2-yard gain.
And that should end the third quarter. North Stanley Comets 32, West Stanley Colts 28. We'll be right back after this.
Charles Kersiel for the San Jose Press alongside Brian Carter of Carter Video Services. Third down and 10 for the Comets. Williams makes one move, but he is going to lose three more yards.
And Connor, who's that in on the tackle?
Connor Edwards along with number 40, Drew Kidd. So Williams loses 3 yards. Or maybe a yard, actually. Only going to be able to yard loss.
Yeah, that's not going to hurt
fourth
stats too
much. Fourth
down
and about 12. And I believe North Stanley has taken a timeout. We'll take his one as well. 11:30 left, fourth quarter. Fourth down and 12 for the Comets. They need to get to the, looks like around the 15-yard line.
And listen to that crowd.
The Colt crazies on their feet exhorting West Stanley's defense. Crisco back to pass, only 4 rushing. Throws the ball, caught! First down inside the 5.
Tyler Reynolds.
And it's Tyler Reynolds. When you need a long pass complete, what else do you do but throw it to a senior with terrific hands to catch the football just like that.
And the throw looked a little wobbly.
It was wobbly, and it was actually a little underthrown.
Yeah,
and
he was right on it.
Tyler did a great job to correct for that.
We've seen some beautiful passes and catches tonight.
Seen a lot of offense in this game as well. First and goal now for the Comets at the 5. Crisco looks like he's checking off the play on the line. He's going to give it to Williams. Williams strung out on the right side, still on his feet. One guy's got his jersey. Three other guys are trying to stop him. He can't.
Williams around the right side for the Comets. Took it down close to the goal line.
Down to the 1 yard line. I bring up second and goal, but he's just.
He picked up like 3-4 yards just on sheer power.
Well, you know, we talk about yards after contact. Yaks. We always talk about those. That's 4 yards that he gained. He was stopped right at the line of scrimmage on the outside. But they had his jersey, like pulling his jersey down. But what they did was they couldn't get it. He kept the legs churning. They could not stop him, and he just kept moving. And he moved the pile down to the 1.
That's
or maybe
of a
the
great
2,
player.
Actually. Second and goal. Oh, it's the up back. Number 2, number 30, excuse me.
No gain there.
He did not get in. He may have gotten about a yard. That was Mike Peoples on the carry. Now third and goal.
Clock continuing to run with 10:55 left.
Interesting decisions coming up because a field goal would only make it a 7-point game. Had they gotten their extra points, it would have been a 2-possession game.
So
would have been
very, very important for the Colts defense to stand up right now.
That's almost a must stop. It's third and goal. Williams off the right side. He's in. Touchdown, North Stanley Comets.
But you're not going to stop a freight train like Mr. Williams.
It is extremely hard. You have to just get penetration through the line and stop him. But once he gets ahead of steam,
you didn't.
There are very, very few people in high school that are going to stop a kid that strong, that fast, when he's got that much momentum going. 10 minutes and 29 seconds left. A 10-point game will be 11 if Billingsley can convert on this extra point. And the kick is no good. He stutter stepped, had a problem.
Kicked it into the center. Oh, well, it happened.
So the score remains 38-28. North Stanley over West Stanley, 10:29 left in the fourth quarter. We'll be back on Stanley County Monday Night Football. A 1-yard touchdown run for Antonio Williams, now with 22 carries, 357 net yards. And his fifth scores his fifth TD of the game, and it's now 38-28. A very short kick this time. Oh, fumble on the play. The ball is still loose, and finally Wes Stanley covers it around the 30.
The band sounding great for North Stanley tonight.
I think North Stanley did not want to try to give Rowe or another one of the tremendous athletes that West Stanley has a chance to kick off, to run a kickoff back.
I mean, Rowe has been very dangerous tonight.
So
keep the ball out of his hands.
Trying to keep the ball out of his hands right there. First and 10 this time, Malik with the off tackle to the left side. Got good blocks in front of him. First down and more. Still going and out of bounds.
Close to midfield.
And a flag comes in late. That may be an extra 15.
Oh, nearly.
Ball is marked at a 48. It's a 15-yard run, but there may be a late a personal foul for a late hit on that one.
Well, see, Mormon seems to be upset.
A couple of times, North Stanley has kind of flirted with those hits on the sidelines.
Yeah, about three times we saw questionable late
and hit. This time it is a late dead ball personal foul against North Stanley. That's 15 additional yards.
Is that not their first penalty of the second half?
I believe it is. It marks the ball down to the 37.
That's a killer penalty right there.
That'll be first and 10 West Stanley at the Comet 37. 10-17 left in the fourth. Colts trail by 10. Jackson off the left side this time. Gets Jackson about three. Comes down in the arms of C.J. Clark. I'm going to give him about 3 yards. That'll bring up second down and 7. Colts with 2 timeouts left. Working without a huddle. Need to try to move a little faster. They've been trying to work, I think, a little faster in this game, especially in the latter parts of the first half and in the third quarter, definitely.
They need to hurry up here. I mean, the clock is still running. We still have 9:40 to go.
Colts need 2 scores, and they need to stop the Comets. Snap is low this time. Jackson gets the handoff. Did not get ahead of steam particularly because of that. Clark with another tackle. That's C.J. Clark, the big freshman. Give him maybe a yard. And it will be third down and 6. Wow, I wonder if these numbers are right. If I type this correctly on our roster, C.J. Clark, 6'2", 265, and he's a freshman.
Whoa.
Let me say that again. He's 6'2", 265,
freshman,
and he's a freshman. Now over the middle looking for Rowe, and it's he's complete. Harris with CJ with the tackle. CJ Harris with the tackle. And fourth down and 5 now. Critical play here. Comet fans rise to their feet. The cowbells get louder. Three wide receivers this time. It's going to be Jackson. Tries to cut up the middle. He is going to come up short at the 30.
Just got tripped up.
And C.J. Harris once again with the tackle.
That'll be a turnover on downs. Comet will take over first and 10.
I get a feeling North is going to try to work that clock some, take as much time as possible off of it.
With 8 minutes and 3 seconds left, North Stanley now sitting in a catbird seat, leading by two scores, by 10 points, 38-28. With 8 minutes left. You know, Brian, in the years that we've been In the years that we've been doing these games, I don't remember ever seeing someone rush for 400 yards.
I don't either.
And he's not there yet, but he is approaching that number.
I'm sure in the back of his mind he would like to break that record.
I don't know what the state record is. I think it's around 500 or so.
Oh, gosh.
I do have internet. I will try to check that very quickly. Second down and 7. Clock continuing to run. 7:20 now. Williams off the right side, and he is stopped.
Williams around the right side.
Maybe back to the line, original line of scrimmage, but not much more.
I see Edwards lost his helmet, and he's still on the ground.
Actually, the most... Okay, I'm still scrolling, and I'll find it in a minute.
Let's see. This is.
And that's a big injury if that.
Yeah.
Unless it's just a cramp, is Mr. Edwards. So no gain on the play. It's 3rd down and 7 now.
Oh, yeah, he's flinching. That's a cramp.
T.M. McClendon actually has 9,038 career yards in his time. I'm trying to find the individual single game. The single game record is 510 yards that T.J. Logan had for Northern Guilford against Charlotte Catholic 3 years ago in the state 3AA championship. Boy, if you're going to run for 500 yards, what better place to do it than in a state championship game?
Oh,
that's
really
tremendous. We're going to take a quick timeout. We'll be right back on Stanley County Monday Night Football. So North Stanley facing 3rd down and 7 now. I formation this time. 9 people, looks like 8 people in the box are trying to stop Williams. They'll fake one and they'll give to Williams, and Williams hits his own blocker and is finished off hard by Izaguirre.
Looks like for a loss.
Drew Kidd was in there as well.
Williams up the middle, bring up 4th down for the Cowboys.
And this bring up a punting situation.
And they'll mark the loss back to the 31, a loss of 2. Brings up 4th down and 9. And just in case you're wondering what those last runs have done to Williams' yardage, he actually is now at 25 carries, 358 yards. Still a 14.3 yard average. C.J. Harris to punt, and Izaguirre standing at the Colt 30. Clock now running, 6:15 left. Still no pressure, trying to set up a return, but the punt is going to roll short and be downed. They probably could have gained another 5 yards if the 89 rush would have let it go. But nonetheless, it'll be stopped.
C.J. Harris is doing his job tonight.
Colts will take up on offense, 1st and 10.
So the ball changed hands again, 6:09 left. And West Stanley, like we're fond of saying, you know, time is not, as the Rolling Stones said, time is not on their side in this case. Facing nearly 70 yards of field in front of them and needing 2 scores in this game. That last turnover really turned into a much needed score for the Comets to continue. They're having to play this game sort of a matching each other score for score and for a while there. And now it's put up a situation where the Colts need 2 scores and they need them in a hurry.
Well, like I said, I think they look a little fresher than North right at this point in the game, and they do have a lot of weapons.
Jackson, no, it's going to be a reverse to Rowe. Rowe's got a wide open field in front of him if he can turn the corner. Tyler Reynolds is going to get him. Oh, Tyler Reynolds made a tremendous play there, and the clock will stop to move the chains. But I'm telling you right now, Tyler Reynolds made a tremendous play just in just keeping his pursuit angle. He gave up the 1st down, but he didn't give up anything longer.
Yeah.
And that's what the Comets have to avoid at this point. The Colts is what they need is a fast score. looking to throw. Under pressure, gets rid of the football, and it is picked off by C.J. Harris. And he's got blockers in front of him. 45, runs over one man, down to the 40.
Did you see that? He just ran over.
Absolutely bowled him over.
Great job, Mr. Harris.
Returns it to the Colt 41-yard line.
I think Mr. Harris is get in contention for player of the week here.
Well, there are several players that deserve a lot of credit for this win.
Oh, yeah.
It's hard when you score five touchdowns and had 350 yards not to give it, of course, yeah. to Antonio Williams.
But
there's definitely some honorable mentions and such.
The whole team's just been playing great. I mean, on both sides.
Team has been solid. North Stanley has been solid in this game. And give West Stanley a lot of credit. They have fought, but another turnover. Williams off the left side, 35, and down around the 34.
Around the left side for the Comets. Gain of about 5 or 6.
They're going to give him 6 on the play. It'll bring up 2nd down and 4. And now the fullback, Mike Peoples, is down. Williams up to 364 now on the official High School Athletic Association record book. They record every game of 350 or above, so Williams can etch his name in another place on that in that particular record book. By my count, he entered this season, he was already 26th or like 25, 27, 28th in the state already in career yards. He's moved up to 14th before this game, and this effort may move him up even further.
Yeah, that young man is on his way.
Taking a long look and now getting off the field, and I believe that's maybe another cramper. Ooh, he's having some problems putting weight on his right ankle. That could be even a bit of an ankle sprain. As a team, North Stanley, 366 yards on 39 carries, 9.4 yards per carry. West Stanley's numbers, nothing to sneeze at either. The 37 carries, 222 yards. Malik Jackson has had a solid game, 27 carries, 187 yards, and 2 touchdowns as well. Not to be lost in the efforts of Williams has been the efforts of Malik Jackson in this game. But the Comets in the driver's seat now can run a couple more minutes, maybe 1 or 2 first downs, and really put West Stanley at a terrible disadvantage.
And the clock's run with 5:20.
Full house backfield this time. Haven't seen this look yet. Going to be Williams off the right side. Look at him turn on the speed. Just does get around, still on his feet. Finally gets tackled around the 28. It's about 6 yards.
Rip his jersey off.
Well, they're trying desperately to get a turnover at this point. Turnovers have been a huge stat in this game. West Stanley has been picked off 3 times and has fumbled twice. North Stanley has not had a turnover.
That's a nice stat for him.
Clichés may be old and rotten, but sometimes there's always some little truth in them. And turnovers will kill you is something you always hear in football. And it has really been the case tonight. Ooh, a little fumble that time. C.J. Harris gets the carry.
41.
Not a whole lot of room particularly. Maybe a yard or two. Bring up 2nd down and 8. Clock running, 4:19 left.
I say West Stanley has 2 timeouts.
2 timeouts left.
Now, when do you start using those, Charles?
I think West Stanley has to get. If North Stanley gets another first down, I think you have to burn the 2 timeouts.
Yeah, North Stanley's content to let that clock run.
Oh, they're going
to, running.
They're going to get every bit of it they can. JT Bost is the back judge tonight, and he's now counting down. And when he starts waving his arm, that means it's left just a few seconds left to run the play. And now the give is to number 20, Cameron Davis. And Davis,
number 20, Cameron Davis around the right
pushes
side
the pile the down around the right side to maybe the 21, about a five-yard gain. Sets up another short third down, third and three. And the Comets only need about one or two more of those and could call this one a night.
And again, taking their time right here. Still in the huddle. And we are at the three-minute mark.
Third down and three now. The full house backfield once again. Almost a reverse wishbone, if you will. Taking a long time for the snap. Now Williams off the left side. Look out, he is gone. Touchdown, North Stanley Comets. That's touchdown number six.
Sort of icing on the cake there.
21-yard touchdown run. It's now 44-28, pending the point after. And he is so close to 400 yards. 391 yards now on 28 carries and six touchdowns.
We have not seen a performance.
We have not seen a performance like that in a very long time. That looks like they may be going for two here. Indeed, they are. Would make it 46-28. Would make it an 18-point game. Around the right side, nothing happening.
20 around the right side for the Comets. The two-point conversion is no good.
So with 2:42 left in the fourth quarter, it's now 44-28.
Comets 44.
We'll be back in just a moment. 28 carries, 391 yards for Williams in this game. And the 21-yard touchdown run is just an impressive performance by the senior Wisconsin commit. Now Rowe takes it at the 15, 20, 25, 30. Still getting behind his blockers. 35, changes fields. He might be able to find some room. And he's still on his feet. 45, 50, still going. Look at the effort of Taylen Rowe down to the Comet 41.
He's just an incredible athlete. Great asset to the offense of the Colts.
First and 10 now for West Stanley at the 42. 2:27 left. The Colts bid to win tonight, the Stanley Cup tonight.
Might have to wait a while.
They're gonna have, may have to wait just to see what happens with North Stanley in their two games against Albemarle and South Stanley. With two men moving at the same time, the direct snap to Izaguirre.
C.J. Harris comes in for the tackle.
Trying a little direct snap trickery there, but it lost 6 yards to bring up, excuse me, it lost 7 yards. Bring up second and 16, or 17. Don't forget, folks, our post-game show coming up in just a few minutes. We will have our player of the week.
Any ideas?
Yeah.
I don't know who it could be.
Boone now looking to throw. Throws it towards the far sidelines and is almost picked off again, this time by Antoine Sloan.
Number four, Antoine Sloan.
Sloan was playing center fielder there and just had it knocked away. at the last second. That brings up third down.
Clock stopped with 1:41 to go in this game.
8 of 16. Christian Boone is 8 of 16 in this game for 107 yards, two touchdowns, but three interceptions. Now I believe we may have a timeout on the field. We'll take one as well and be right back. And just coming back, we apologize, folks. We got back a little before we were ready, and the pass is intercepted. C.J. Crisco with another interception. At the Comet 35-yard line. One minute, 35 seconds left. Make that six turnovers in the game for Wes Stanley.
Turnovers will kill you.
And now with only one timeout left, Comets can
pretty much run the clock out
with a couple of knees.
Well, it's been a pleasure calling the game with you here, Charles.
Oh, same
too. It's been a very good game. Both teams deserve a lot of credit. They played their hearts out.
I wonder if Williams will get a carry here. No, I don't believe he will. Well, he may.
Just to break that
400. And it's Williams off the right side. Gains about 2 yards. A late flag comes flying in.
34 up the middle for the Comets, Antonio Williams.
It's about 2 yards, but I believe it's a holding penalty is going to negate that. Personal foul, excuse me, face mat against
Wes Stanley. So I'll give him 15.
So they first and 10 now at the Colt 48, and the Comets can run the clock out. And now Williams is out of the game, I believe. Crisco taking as much time as he can, waiting for the back judge who's timing the play clock. Gives it to Davis. And Davis for a no gain on the play.
He might have even lost a yard. We've got 55 seconds left to go in this contest.
No gain on the play. One more play and this game is over. Crisco can take a knee. And it looks like that's exactly what he's going to do. And this ball game is over. Your final score, North Stanley 44, West Stanley 28. We'll be back with a post-game show on Stanley County Monday Night Football. We're here on the postgame show on Stanley County Monday Night Football. We're going to have two players of the week, one defense and one offense. And let's start first defensively with C.J. Harris. Two interceptions tonight, six turnovers for the Comets on defense. Talk a little bit about your team's defensive efforts tonight.
They put in a great effort. We've been practicing for it all week. I just couldn't do it without them.
with Wes Stanley, it was a time when it was sort of matching touchdown for touchdown, but in the later in that third and then in the fourth quarter, it seemed like you guys got a little more momentum and you got the stops when you needed them.
Yes, sir. We talked over their plays in the locker room at halftime, and we just learned how to put it together out here.
How big a win is this for you guys?
Pretty big, sir.
All right, and now offensively, of course, 391 yards and six touchdowns. Antonio, obviously your best effort, I believe, in your career at North Stanley. Talk a little bit about these guys behind you and what their efforts meant to you tonight.
Oh, well, I've actually been battling the sickness all week. I had a virus, still feeling it. And these guys just picked me up when I felt down. You know, I couldn't ask for any other blocking besides these guys. I've been with them for my 4 years now, and each year we've just got better as a group. So, you know, they're great. They're great.
Wes Stanley had a chance to win the Stanley Cup with a win tonight. Was that a motivating factor for you guys this week?
We have better intentions for ourselves. They were just an obstacle in the way. We got them out the way. Now we're moving on.
How do you keep this momentum going?
We just stay focused, take it one game at a time. We're not looking too far ahead. What comes next is what we're worried about.
Antonio Williams, our co-player of the week here on Stanley County Monday Night Football. Back on the postgame show on Stanley County Monday Night Football with head coach Scott Crisco getting congratulations from his teammates, from his team. Coach, let's talk a little bit first defensively. Six turnovers that you forced in this game. Talk about your team's defensive effort and kind of what your scheme was coming in.
Well, mostly our defense, our scheme was to contain Malik, and we did. So he's a great learner. You're not going to hold him back all the time, but we contained him a little bit. Defense, that was our goal, was to make turnovers and create turnovers. We hadn't done that in the past, but, yeah, we come through big on interceptions today. C.J. Harris and Austin Size come up big for us.
And those fumbles converted, you know, immediately into offense. Antonio, 391 yards and six touchdowns. He seems to get better and better the more he plays.
Yeah. The scary thing is he's playing probably the best I've ever seen him play. He's got a one mind. He's got a goal. And he's team oriented. I can't say enough about him.
Well, the offensive line obviously gets a lot of credit for their blocking up front as well. Just what does this win mean to you to you personally, and then for this program?
Well, first of all, I told the team there, you don't get 390 yards on your own. They have good, great blocking. Our O-line come out big. But this was a great win for us. For one, it keeps us in the County Cup race. It sets the tone for the conference. We start conference play next week. Gives a little motivation to keep going.
Well, Coach, congratulations on the win.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
We'll be back in just a moment. So North Stanley 44, West Stanley 28. The Comets stay in the race for the Stanley Cup. The Colts finish with a 2-1 record in county play this year. We'll be here again next week as North Stanley will open conference play against South Davidson. For my partner Brian Carter of Carter Video Services, I'm Charles Curcio. We'll see you in the Stanley News and Press on the weekend edition, and I'll see you next week on TV.
Football is a 20th century technological struggle.
And what I seen was this whole raft of people a-setting on these two banks and looking at one another across this pretty little green cow pasture.
Football has hitting, clipping, spearing, blocking, punting, late hitting, unnecessary roughness, and personal fouls.
And